Welcome to Faces, a programme by me, the Gabbie Cabbie, and Rachel Brown. Two mics, one vision. Linking up with artists and introducing them to Northern Exposure on SRB Radio. On this show, I'm joined by a four-piece Scottish band from Dundee named Vladimir, who recently done a 10-minute slot with Rachel Brown. Welcome to Birmingham, young man.
Welcome.
And welcome to SRB Radio. And welcome to Northern Exposure.
Oh, thank you very much.
Tell me all about the band. As I say, four-piece. I want a name check. Vocals, guitar, drum and bass.
Yeah, I'm Ross. I do vocals.
Sam play drums.
James play bass.
And Peter, I play guitar.
Now, you're in the middle of a UK tour.
Yeah.
You obviously started in Scotland. You're then going to end in Scotland. Yeah. And you've been to Sheffield, you've been to Birmingham, London. So tell me briefly how it's gone for you.
It's been good. I've played a few places I've never been before. It's been cool and it's been good. Been good response. Mm-hmm. It's always a bit worrying because we're so far away compared to them here and coming down. But it's been good because everyone's been dead nice to win that. But some of the venues have no like been what we're used to, so we've kind of had to adapt a bit to it and stuff. It's been really good to, and I think the rest of the lads have enjoyed it.
What's life like on the road? Because we're out here on Smallbrook Queensway, which is the hub of Birmingham. The traffic are flying past us. You're in your tour bus. It's hard graft. You've got all your equipment in there. You're having, obviously, overnight stays. Where's the most memorable venue that you've played so far? And the biggest, the best reception that you've had?
Played at the Kirt Hall in Dundee, like, hometown show, with a view. So that was, like, growing up, that's what you want to do if you're from Dundee.
Yeah.
That was pretty cool. We played Rock City in Nottingham, which with the Libertines. It was like a dream as well. But kind of quite enjoy the wee venue as well. We're playing the Old Blue Last tomorrow in London. Mm-hmm. That's just a wee venue, but it's really cool. It's a good setup in that. But yeah, probably the Cured Hall was like the one for a Dundee band, and it's just like kind of it's what you start a Dundee band to do. You know what I mean, play the Cured Hall.
The name Vladimir, where did it come from?
Pete had that idea.
Right.
I don't really know. There was nothing specifically where it came from. I didn't want to name the band something like the, I wanted a name or something that would maybe stick around.
Yeah.
So yeah, I decided on a name, like rather than.
So how did you come about? Because it's rather Russian, isn't it?
Yeah.
For a Scottish band.
Yeah. I don't know. It was just completely random. I think Russia is an interesting place. I think. I've never been.
Well, you ain't been yet, but you might
hopefully,
be.
Yeah, maybe no get in playing with that name, mate. It might cause a bit of bother. I'm not sure how it works. Like,
I'm sure you Scottish boys, the Russians ain't going to bother with you.
Definitely. Be all right. Hopefully you get to go through. It looks pretty smart.
Yeah?
I think we'd go down well. They're into pretty, mental shit over there, so be all right.
Describe your style and describe your music. What kind of genre do you fit into?
I don't know. You asked this a lot. I'm not sure actually what we fit into.
Uh-huh.
Don't really know. Probably some post-punk, I don't know. It's quite a lot of things that goes through. A lot of changes in our music.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of always, people always reference to us like The Cure and Jesus Mary Chain and stuff.
Dance music as well.
Yeah, sorry.
Yeah. We like a lot of dance music as well.
Okay.
Stuff, electronic things and we like a little bit of everything there. So, yeah, Jesus Mary Chain, dark bands, but we like to try and combine a bit of everything. We do a cover of Born Slippy, which is a song by Underworld, an electronic song.
Now that's on your SoundCloud account, isn't it?
Yep. We'll be right back. So yeah, we thought we'd do that because a lot of bands cover other guitar bands, so we thought we'd try something different.
It sounds great as well on SoundCloud. Now, who writes your music? What's the dynamics? What happens?
It's a collective effort. We've got like our own wee practice room. It's a bit like grim and that, but work really well in it. Just like before we get together and just jam, and quite good at writing now. It's like it's constantly always something coming for the next. Every practice has got something new and new. Then we just write the music, then I'll put lyrics to it, and it's been working well. Just something about all together in the room, and it just everything always comes together nicely.
Now on a tour, you're usually promoting something.
Yeah.
Whether it be a new single or an album or an EP. What is it that you're promoting on this tour?
We've got a new single coming out on the 29th of April called I Try.
Okay.
Which was just recently recorded. So we're doing this tour, then it'll come out, then we'll do festivals and stuff, then more touring, so hopefully it sells well and stuff and people get to hear more. We just want more and more people to hear our music and get us out there. Because like, these venues have been great, so hopefully the next time we come back we'll be busier and busier and just like snowball, hopefully.
Talk to me about some of the tracks that you've previously released.
We've had like the first proper like single we done was called Come Over, and it was just kind of like before that we were kind of just like kind of kids messing about, and that kind of felt like that was us taking the step up to being a band. Then we've done a single called Smoke Eyes, which we released Born Slippy with together.
Yeah.
Then last year we done In My Head, then we're about to release I Try. But I think it's they're all progressing nicely, and you can see us maturing and getting better as a band, so it's going well. It's going well for us.
Now, festivals, you alluded to festivals. What festivals are you playing this year?
I know we're like confirmed so far, it's like Great Escape,
Tramlings.
Great Escape's in Brighton.
Okay.
We're doing the Doc Martin stage down there for Doc Martin's.
All right.
Then we're doing Tramlings Festival in Sheffield. And then we've got a few more that kind of be announced.
Now that's in July, isn't it, Tramlings?
Yeah.
Are you playing on the Saturday the 23rd?
I'm not sure of the date yet.
Okay.
I'm not sure, but it's on the Crystal stage.
Mm-hmm.
We've got a few more, but I don't think we're allowed to announce them yet. So
okay.
We'll see. Should be soon getting more announced.
Now, the Tramlines Festival, that's the biggest urban festival that's free in the UK, isn't
is it?
It's massive.
Oh, yeah.
It's huge.
Nice. I've played it once before, or twice before. It was good.
Okay.
We were just in a wee room, so I think this time we're playing on a bigger stage.
Yeah.
But we played the other night and it was really good, and walked past where we're going to be, that Crystal stage, walked past that, so it's looking good there.
Now on your 10 minutes with Rachel Brown,
right?
The one question was villain. You said Pat Nevin.
Yeah, have you ever seen him before?
Is it the old Chelsea player in the Scottish International?
Have you seen him like, you just don't get Sports Scene down here, but that home there's like a highlight show called Sports Scene. He's always got this pen in his hand and he's always twiddling it and that, it's just really frustrating. Pretty much right as well, aren't
I? Now, you're a Dundee United. They're all you football supporters as well as musicians.
Nah, they didn't know into sport.
Dundee.
He's winking.
He's
winding you up.
Got a tour of Man City Stadium the other day through Manchester. That was cool. Got like took him around the stands and the trophy room and that. It was really cool.
How about touring like football stadiums and doing a bit of a PA?
What's that? I don't get what you're saying.
We almost need a translator, don't we? You know, like going and doing PAs at football stadiums.
We want to try and like go around all the stadiums and play in, like outside them, because the Man City's got a big stage outside.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
So hopefully we could play on it. The boy there said maybe be able to do it. See what happens.
How about videos? You got any videos out on YouTube? You got a YouTube channel?
I've got one video on YouTube just now for In My Head. Hopefully there might be a video for this one, I'm not sure. Need to wait and see.
How do you think the industry's going these days? Is it good for you guys starting out, or not so good?
It's kind of hard because obviously we're from so far away, so it takes ages to drive here to play.
Yeah.
So it's a lot of money, and you kind of like have a consistent job and being a band.
Yeah.
Then it go hand in hand, so it's really hard. And unless you're really in the loop with people, you don't get much support. But it's good, it's fun, and it's better this way because it shows you what you're made of, doesn't it? It
certainly does.
Bands that get everything handed to them and they've got all the money, it's no last as long.
But this is the best way to do it, isn't it? You know, doing the hard slog, putting your boots on and doing the gigs.
Yeah,
you know,
it's always
playing,
been the way,
playing venues that there's only 40 or 50 people, but 40 or 50 people that's out to come and support you, rather than being on X Factor and having things put in your lap and having to almost sell out to sell your music.
Yeah, I think we've always just kind of seen it as like practice, get in the van, play a gig, go back, practice again, and just took it like that. Yeah, it's always... Hard work makes it pay off, surely.
I think hard work hopefully does pay off.
Yeah.
But there's nothing like hard work, is there?
No.
Are you writing stuff while you're on the road as well?
We're always writing stuff, like, constantly. Just, like, never stop. Just all the time. Sometimes we don't, like, we'll cover a new song, we won't just put it in right away. We'll kind of, like, make sure it's in at the right time and stuff. So, mm-hmm. I've always got loads and loads of songs, yeah.
So, who's your main influences collectively? If you know, you've alluded to Mary and, you know, Jesus and the Mary Jane gang and stuff and what have you. How about yourself, young man? What were you brought up on in your house?
The Beatles, to start off with.
Yeah.
And then started branching out. Started listening to a lot more Interpol and just kind of sped off from there. Like Peter said, Jesus and Mary Jane are a big example, and that just kind of comes naturally, kind of seems to fit.
How about Scottish bands? I mean, there's a lot of great Scottish bands out there. Are you guys going to be the next big great thing from Scotland?
I don't really want to answer that. We'll see what happens.
Yeah.
We'll try our hardest to do that and get about and play gigs. So we'll see what happens. Yeah.
That's all you can do, isn't it? Facebook and Twitter and social media, obviously they're an absolute bonus and a must, aren't they?
Yeah.
For young artists starting out.
Yeah, I think we've always kind of had like an ongoing battle with social media and stuff.
In what way?
I don't think we like to like see loads of bands like speaking loads and loads and loads on them, and I just think like none of it equals to the music you've got. I mean, it's just like you've got to surely like back up your talking on social media and music.
Yeah.
So I always kind of rather make our music do the talking rather than posting pictures of us, you know what I mean, like eating food and stuff. It's just totally pointless.
No one wants to see what bands are eating for their tea, really. Oh, well, maybe they do, but it's a lot of spamming and stuff on that, so we try to just keep it, you know, to the point, and I think we don't like, there's too much on social media these days, eh? It gives it all away, you know.
I think you're right.
No mystery things anymore now,
Nothing. I think that is a valid point. It's, you know, do you give everything away because people can just download it for free, etc., etc.? I mean, you've got vinyl that people struggle to download vinyl for free.
Yeah.
I mean, that's an avenue that is coming back. And have you got anything else on vinyl, for instance?
Nah, we want to, but we've just not got the money. Yeah, it's quite hard up, like.
Yeah.
But hopefully, eventually, we have been looking into it. But it's, end of the day, it's all down to money. We're like young, struggling bands. So you kind of just not got hundreds of pounds to throw about at vinyls and stuff. So I think we're just trying to do the best we can within our means just now, and then see where it goes. But as Peter said, like, we didn't want to give everything away before anyone. Because like when I was younger, like finding a new band and listening to the song. And the best thing after that was going and trying to find out everything about them and all their background and stuff.
Yeah.
See, if you've already been told that before you even listen to the band, there's no like excitement left in music anymore, is there? It's just like boring and dull. That's how I think nobody gets excited about bands as much now. Like, you never get like a new band coming out and you're like totally, oh no, let me go try and find out everything about them, because you already know everything about them as soon as you hear the first song. It's, it's a bit like dull, eh? So we want to be a bit different and like maybe make people excited. Like when people have never heard your phone coming to gig, hear you for the first time, you're like, that's the best feeling in the world, finding a new band. Should be the same online, and after that you should need to put a bit of effort in and find out more. Mm. Rather than just knowing it all instantly.
So you like to be dark, you like to be secretive, and I think there's a, you know, a lot of value in that as well, isn't there? I love that earring.
Thanks very much.
Is it painful having it done?
No, it's fine, it's just a wee needle, a couple of minutes, all done. Nothing too extended, no hassle. It's been done before. Once before, it'll be done again.
He's into stuff like that.
Oh, is he? So, off the road, what are you guys into? What's, what's on the horizons and stuff?
Just keep doing what we're doing, this is like, oh, what do we do? We didn't do much else, so.
Yeah. Get to the next gig on time.
that's the main target.
Then a crash.
Mind you, when you get to the London gigs, you better watch it, because there is a lot of congestion down there in the south.
Car hit with the other day on the other side of the van.
Did you really like?
Yeah. Was that right? It's no great. No great.
Prang. Yeah. Prong. Prawn. Yeah. It was a small collision, a junction. It's all good. No one was hurt.
As long as it doesn't cost them money, it's all right. Patter it as much as we want.
Well, again, you only get that from doing what you're doing, don't you?
Exactly,
you can't get that from your bedroom.
Exactly, yeah. Kind of break your gear from your bedroom either, and we've broke a lot of that recently, so. But it's better fun, is it?
Yeah. It's all about fun, it's all about enjoying it,
exactly.
It's all about getting the music out there, getting the punters in, and getting some money in your pocket so you can invest and you can move on and you can progress as well.
It's all about the total like excitement and buzz as well. Like seeing you're on stage, you can see people getting excited about you, then you get excited. It's like it's the total what everyone works.
It's a buzz, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah, exactly. You know,
people singing back your lyrics. That must be such a feeling.
If a band loses that, I don't think there's any point in going. Like, what's the point going on stage? You're not excited to do it anymore. Like, sometimes you can watch a band and think, you're not that bothered about being up there. That's just like going through the motions. Mm-hmm. Never want to be like that. Not saying on stage we've got like big massive smiles and that, but
we don't need to, do you? Exactly. Like, just play
like,
music,
because like music does that for us. Yeah, exactly.
I did notice on the picture we took. I mean, there weren't many smiling anyhow. But you know, there's nothing. There's no rule that says you've got to have smiley faces. You've got to look like a bunch of idiots while you're on there. You can be as moody as you like, but your music is what. Well, your music is everything, isn't it? You know, to be quite truthful. Yeah, it's all about the music. So your Facebook and your Twitter feed, so people can then hook up with you, and your website as well. What are they?
Facebook's www.facebook.com/Vladimir Dundee, and Twitter is twitter.com/Vladimir Dundee.
SoundCloud. We've got SoundCloud. SoundCloud/Vladimir UK. Yeah, they're all different links. Vladimir UK.
No uniform there with Vladimir.
Nah, just go for it.
But if you put Vladimir into a search engine, you'll either get you guys from Dundee or some freak from Russia.
Yeah.
You know?
Hopefully the first one.
It's never going to be us that they find first, is it?
They usually put Dundee or UK or band after it, because there's a lot of Vladimirs in this small planet.
Well, guys, can I thank you for your time?
Thank you very much.
Have a great stay in Birmingham, and enjoy the rest of your tour. And another, when do you say your record is out again? Let's have another shout for it.
I Try's out on the 29th of April on iTunes, Spotify, all the usual online stuff. And well, maybe you have some physical CDs as well going up on sale and available at gigs too.
And will there be an album in the pipeline?
One day,
yeah, okay.
Just don't know when.
Any plans to sign to a label? Are you with a label?
If a label wants us, I'd have us, but we'll see. Nah, we're not bothered. If someone gives us a load of cash, we'll release an album. Yeah. Right? We don't need a label.
Work in progress.
Anyone wants to email us with money, they're more than welcome.
Which is your
VladimirUK1@gmail.com.
PayPal.
Boys, have a great time, seriously.
Yes, thank you very much.
Thank you. Cheers, lads.
Cheers.
Okay, thanks for listening. Good night and God bless.
Sure.